I just take a picture.
This is the reason.
their brothers and sisters, on behalf of Tyler and Jordan, on behalf of their families, and on behalf of our parish family, welcome, welcome to St. Pius. We're glad you came. But I'm not glad that that bird came. If you see a bird flying around, that bird was not invited, and we'll just pretend it's the Holy Spirit. But for now, if you would please pick up one of the worship aids, and then if you would please turn it to the inside cover to page two, and we raise our voices as we sing together, "Lift Up Your Hearts." In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Tyler and Jordan, the church shares your joy and warmly welcomes you, together with your families and friends and bird, as today, in the presence of God our Father, you establish between yourselves a lifelong partnership. May the Lord hear you on this your joyful day. May the Lord send you help from heaven and protect you. May the Lord grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your prayers. On the day that Jesus was born, the angels sang, "Glory be to God in the highest," in Bethlehem. We sing the same thing today at the birth of the church. And you'll find that at 3.
Glory to God in the highest.
Yeah.
Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness, pour out your grace on these your servants, Tyler and Jordan, that coming together before your altar, they may be confirmed in love for one another, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all the wild animals and all the creatures that crawl on the ground." God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on the earth." God looked at everything he had made, and he found it very good. The word of the Lord.
Rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The hand of the Lord has struck with power. His right hand is exalted. I shall not die, but live anew, declaring the works of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. The Lord of love and mercy has brought wonder to our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be
glad. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. Let love be sincere. Hate what is evil. Hold on to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Anticipate one another in showing honor. Do not grow slack in zeal. Be fervent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Endure in affliction. Persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the holy ones. Exercise hospitality. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Not everyone who calls me Lord, Lord will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father in heaven. Everyone who listens to these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on rock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house, but it did not collapse. It had been set solidly on rock. And everyone who listens to these words of mine but does not act on them will be like a fool who built his house on sand. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house, and it collapsed and was completely ruined." When Jesus finished these words, the crowds were astonished at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority and not as their scribes. The Gospel of the Lord. Tyler and Jordan, I don't know if you planned it this way, but getting married during the Easter season is wonderful. You know, for starters, you don't have to decorate the altar. It's already done that. You have an Easter candle that matches your bridesmaid's colors. The bird is extra. But the most important thing about getting married in the Easter season is your belief in resurrection. You know, for 40 days during the season of Lent, we focused on the Lord's suffering and passion. In the sacred Paschal Triduum on Good Friday, we commemorated the fact that Jesus Christ died, that he went into death. And then, of course, in that evening and on Easter Sunday, and for 40 days, we proclaimed the resurrection. And that's the Paschal mystery. The essence of the Paschal mystery is that Jesus's death is not the end, and his resurrection is what happens when he dies. And his promise is promise that those who die with him will rise with him. And so it's a good time to see marriage as an important participation in the Paschal mystery. There'll be plenty of dying in this marriage. If you don't believe me, you can ask people who are married already. You know, that's part of the mystery, that mystery of dying to yourself, dying to what you want, you know, trusting that you can live for each other. Tyler passed the test just before we began. Somebody asked the question. He says, oh, whatever Jordan says. Yep, you're on the right track. He's on his way already, but you got to do it too. You know, and in living the Paschal mystery, you become a source of hope for the rest of us. You really do, by entering into that dying and trusting in that rising on a daily basis. Not only as physicians do you bring healing to people, but as a married couple, you bring light, resurrection in the midst of a dark world, in a world where there's a lot of divisions, a lot of anger, and you bring love. You know, Jesus promises that when you build your house, this expression of the Paschal mystery on rock, on solid ground, it'll last. Who knows what's going to happen during your marriage? We can't control that. You know, forming a sacrament now does not protect you from all the vicissitudes of life. But you've established your marriage, your intention to live this Paschal mystery in this unique way, not only in your profound love for each other, but also in your deep faith in Jesus Christ and your trust that no matter how many times you have to die, there will always be resurrection in the Lord's presence. So thank you for taking this step in faith. Thank you for being a light to the rest of us. And may the Lord grant you many happy years and the courage to live this mystery. My dear friends, Tyler and Jordan, you've come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with the sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens you, those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Tyler and Jordan, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
We have.
Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
We are.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
We are.
That's the right answer. Since it's your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, with your hands joined, declare your consent before God and his church.
I, Tyler, take you, Jordan, to be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life.
I, Jordan, take you, Tyler, to be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life.
May the Lord in his goodness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you. What God joins together, let no one put asunder.
Amen, amen, amen.
Bless and sanctify your servants in their love, O Lord, and let these rings, a sign of their faithfulness, remind them of their love for one another, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Jordan, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Tyler, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we call to mind the special gift of grace and charity by which God has been pleased to crown and consecrate the love of our sister Jordan and our brother Tyler, let us commend them to the Lord, and to each of these prayers, please respond with the words, Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, may our faith and love God has for her be expressed in our love for one another. We pray to the Lord. For our world and its leaders, may all people be treated with dignity they deserve as God's children. We pray to the Lord. For Tyler and Jordan, may their love for each other continue to grow, and may they have a long, happy, and blessed marriage. We pray to the Lord. For our married couples, may they continue to grow in wisdom and grace, and reflect God's love to all around them. We pray to the Lord. For peace in our hearts, in our families, and throughout the world, may the Lord make us instruments of his grace all the days of our life. We pray to the Lord. For those who are sick, lonely, discouraged, or suffer in any way, may they be strengthened by God's help and aided by those around them. We pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially Steve and Paul Geroski, Grandma and Grandpa Geroski, Granny and Papa Schmidt, Aunt Lynn and Uncle David Swartzwelder, Uncle Frank Safransky, Aunt Vicki Schmitz, Grandma Erville Reamsnyder, Great Uncle Charlie and Great Aunt Janet Reamsnyder, and Aunt Lolita Appel. Although they are not here with us, may they know our love and share our joy. We pray to the Lord. For those prayers which we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Graciously pour out upon this husband and wife, O Lord, the spirit of your love, to make them one heart and one soul, so that nothing whatever may divide those you have joined, and no harm come to those you have filled with your blessing, through Christ our Lord.
As the Lord's table is prepared, we sing from the worship aid, Where Charity and Love Prevail.
Grateful joy and holy fear, His charity we learn.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive in your kindness, Lord, the offerings we bring in gladness before you, and in your fatherly love, watch over those who have joined in a sacramental covenant through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in him you have made a new covenant with your people, so that as you have redeemed man and woman by the mystery of Christ's death and resurrection, so in Christ you might make them partakers of divine nature, and join heirs with him of heavenly glory. In the union of husband and wife, you give a sign of Christ's loving gift of grace, so that the sacrament we celebrate might draw us back more deeply into the wondrous design of your love. And so with the angels and all the saints, we praise you, and without end, we acclaim. Kneel, but if kneeling's not your custom, you may be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy. Oh my gosh. That's the wrong Holy Spirit. Giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Be mindful also, Lord, of Tyler and Jordan, whom you have brought to their wedding day, so that by your grace they may abide in mutual love and in peace. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us humbly invoke by our prayers, dear brothers and sisters, God's blessing upon this bride and groom, that in his kindness he may favor with his help those on whom he has bestowed the sacrament of matrimony. Holy Father, maker of the whole world, who created man and woman in your own image and willed that their union be crowned with your blessing, we humbly beseech you for these your servants who are joined today in the sacrament of matrimony. May your abundant blessing, Lord, come down upon this bride, Jordan, and upon Tyler, her companion for life. And may the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out together the gift of matrimony, they may adorn their family with children and enrich the church. In happiness, may they praise you, O Lord. In sorrow, may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil and know that you are near to comfort them in their need. Let them pray to you in the Holy Assembly and bear witness to you in the world. And after a happy old age, together with a circle of friends that surrounds them, may they come to the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We offer one another the sign of peace.
Have mercy on us. sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Please kneel, but if that's not your custom, please be seated. We're now invited to come forward once the bridal party is received to receive the body and blood of the Lord. And so please come down the center aisle singing the Lord's praises. And once you've received for the body of Christ, you can drink from the chalice as you go back by the side aisle. If you're not in full communion with the Catholic Church or not ready to receive, we invite you to come for a blessing. And to signal that you'd like a blessing, just cross your arms like this. And if you need a low gluten host, come to me. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I called the Lord and answered me. From all my troubles, he set me free. Taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness. Taste and see the good.
Let us pray. Having been made partakers at your table, we pray, O Lord, that those who are united by the sacrament of marriage may always hold fast to you and proclaim your name to the world through Christ our Lord. Amen. On behalf of Dr. and Dr. Tyler Reamsnyder, or Mr. and Mrs., whatever they want to go by, thank you so much. Thank you so much for your participation, and most importantly, for your support in their marriage. Right after, if all of you would just please follow us down the aisle, walk in procession down the aisle, follow them, and then you'll go through the first set of doors. It stopped raining, don't worry about it. You'll go through the first set of doors, go into the second set of doors, and that's the Parish Life Center, and please hang out there as long as you want, and that'll keep the church quiet, and we really appreciate you doing that. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May God, the all-powerful Father, grant you his joy and bless you and your children. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the only begotten Son of God stand by you with compassion in good times and in bad. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit of God always pour forth his love into your hearts. Through Christ our Lord. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.